This is a mess. Now before I jump into the video, I just want to give a shout out to Cricut for sponsoring this video. So today on Six Sisters Stuff, I'm showing you how I organize my pantry to make it functional instead of really pretty. Now in my 14 years of marriage, almost 15, we have traveled all over the nation and have lived in what? 10 different houses. Now with each house, we've had different sizes of pantries. We've had cupboards that had to be my pantry, and then we've had pretty much nothing at all. We used to store food underneath my bed. Now when we built this house, I wanted to make sure that I had a large enough pantry to fit everything for me and my four kids. My main priorities were convenient, functional, and it had to be able to stay clean. All right guys, if you're ready, let's just jump right in. So the first thing you want to do is get a lot of different bins and baskets. Now this might sound funny that this is the first thing you want to do, but I had an amazing friend who is so good at organizing. She came and she helped me pick all kinds of bins and baskets, all kinds. Just make sure you keep the receipts because whatever you're not gonna use, you can return it. But we wanted to have enough selection that we were able to kind of move things around. Like, oh, this fits in this basket, but it's not really gonna fit in this one. So lots of options. That is my best suggestion. Whatever budget you're on, shop that area. I love finding bins and baskets at TJ Maxx, at Walmart, at the Dollar Tree. You can find some amazing ones at Target. It kind of just depends on what your budget is and how much you wanna spend. So number two is take everything out of your pantry. Now we moved in during COVID, so that means we didn't have any help. My husband and I, we moved everything into our house. So there was a lot of things going into the pantry that probably shouldn't be there. And it has taken me, yes, I admit this, over a year to take everything out. So literally everything is getting out. Right, coming along, just taking everything out. And yeah, hopefully finding a new place for it. Ooh-wee. Number three, it's time to wipe everything down. Now, because we moved so much, I actually did this quite often because we would move and I had to wipe it all down anyways. But every year to 2 years, try and take everything out, wipe it down, make sure things are good and you don't have crazy spills anywhere. So that's what I like to do, wipe everything down, wipe the floors, floorboards, everything. Let's get it clean. Now, number four is I wanted to make my pantry work for me and my family. The thing that I struggled with the most are the cereal boxes. We love cereal at our house. I know. The problem was is that sometimes we'd have like 8 or 9 boxes open, and if they didn't like one cereal, then it would just get stale and disgusting. So I have loved pouring my cereal into bins. I never thought I would say this. I love pouring it into bins because that means we only have 6 available. And then when one is gone, you can take a cereal box and fill it up with that. It keeps it fresh, it keeps it good, and my kids, you have 6 options. These are your options. If they run out, find something else. Now in my cupboard, I have really big shelves. So my friend suggested that I get a spinner, and I never thought I would love spinners as much as I do. So I keep the items that I use the most on the spinners, and then I keep the extras down below on a different shelf, just so what my kids know if they're looking for honey, peanut butter, Nutella, any of those common things that we use, they're on a certain spinner. Or all of my oils or cooking things, those are on their own spinner. That way we won't be opening multiple things and they're super easy to find. Spinners are great, especially if you have small spaces. All right, I wanna talk about snacks for just a minute. I am a believer that there should be snacks in houses. What I like to do is have a big bin full of my kids' favorite snacks. It's actually wonderful to have such a big bin because when I bring home the groceries, the kids can actually open up their snacks and dump it into the big snack bins. Not only that, it's just one less thing for me to do. If kids can do it, we're winning. But we also have a little treat bin. This isn't as big, obviously, because we like to not eat as many treats, but we do have a sweet bin and they have to ask permission before they get anything out of that one. But it just is a perfect place if we're eating like a bag of licorice and there's leftovers, it has a place to go. So the main purpose of these bins is that everything has a place. Now, once you have finally figured out what bins you want certain things in and what containers you want other things in, then it's time to arrange your pantry with those items. Do not label anything yet. Once you have everything nice and tidy and you think you know where you want it, now comes the fun part, the labeling. I decided to label almost everything I possibly could inside of my pantry. I found the best way to label is using the Cricut. So I used a Cricut maker. There's also vinyl and transfer tape. That's really all you need to literally label your whole pantry. Now, lots of times I would get a little frustrated because label makers are kind of hard to use, but with the Cricut maker, the setup is super fast, super easy, and even I can do it. And I am not the most technical person. Now, the one thing I love about the Cricut maker is that you can make labels that are all shapes and sizes. So I literally type in what I want, and then you can actually change the size. So dad snacks, I need to make a little bit smaller because it's going on a smaller container. Now, once I have everything the correct size and I'm ready to go, then it's time to get everything set. So I took my vinyl and went ahead and put it on my Cricut mat. Now the Cricut mat's a little sticky, just so you're aware. And I just like to do little sections at a time. So my dad snacks, that's about how big it's gonna be. Once you're ready, you can click make it. Make sure everything's set up on your computer correctly. You just have to push the Cricut button and it will start going. No, I love watching it. When you're done, go ahead and pull it out and you can see my dad word right here. You just go ahead and peel off your vinyl. It really is so simple. And then those little pieces, I took some tweezers and I just peeled those off. I then took some Cricut transfer tape and I pulled off the end. It's kind of like a sticker, and went ahead and laid it on. Then I had a little thing so I could press it down nicely. If you don't have this, you can use a credit card also. Just pushing it all down and then it will all peel up. Now I went ahead and pressed it one more time just to make sure it will stick on. You're gonna go ahead and peel them apart. Do you want the words to stay on the transfer tape? Now once they are on, I kind of snipped mine so I could do little sections at a time. I'm gonna add dad first, so I kind of center it. You can measure if you want, but you know me, I eyeball all the time. Then go ahead and rub it on. If you don't have this little thing, you can use a credit card. Then carefully peel off the transfer tape. Nice, and then it is on there. It looks amazing. Now, if you don't want to go the vinyl route, that's totally fine. The Cricut Maker can cut up to 300 different items, from thick cardstock to even thin paper. It can even do things such as like foil or leather or even a cereal box or cashmere. I mean, you name it, it can cut it. You can be creative when it comes to making labels, not only for your pantry, but for literally everything else in your house.
Now you have baskets like this. You can grab these tags. I just got them on Amazon that can stick on almost every bin. So then you can still organize.
That is how I labeled my big thing of snacks. So this is kind of my baking shelf. So these are the things that I've labeled. So we have Jell-O and pudding mixes, baking mixes, onions. Head on over here, we have potatoes. I know that is spelled wrong. It's okay. And then, like I said before, my spinner. So this is just one side of the pantry.
Now at the top, we have our hot cocoa and apple cider mixes. Down below, we have lots of other snacks. These are kind of our healthy snacks. They're up high for me and my husband. Marshmallows, yes, they have their own container. Also up high, because my children can eat all of them in one sitting. Next, we have granola bars, or these are actually the protein bars that me and my husband use. I love eating, you can see them. Built bars, and we always make sure we have a giant stash because they're good. A bin for crackers. Now when these crackers are gone, I'll fill up with a different kind of crackers, also with these. So I have two cracker bins going always at the same time. I also love putting all my rice, brown rice, quinoa in containers. These are also my rice packets. You can see there are some back there. I like to organize my spice packets. So this is literally all my packets. So I have my ranch, taco seasoning, and then I love Lipton onion soup mix. One thing I've never done is put my brown sugar, flour, sugar, all those in containers. I love doing this, and if you're wondering, my brown sugar is not dried out. Woohoo! I think this is my favorite section. This is the kids section. So we have some granola bars that they can reach.
a lot of applesauces, and then right down below is the snack bin, the one that I've been showing you.
All right, moving down is the pasta. So I have these little containers. I got them on sale at Walmart, actually. I love when containers go on sale. That's when I usually try and grab them. So this is my pasta shelf. We have mac and cheese, which I'm hoping to fill up the rest of that. These are my leftover pastas. So I actually still have all my boxed pastas, but if I only use a little bit of my pasta, then I have a place to put them. And I actually don't mind mixing my pastas as long as they're kind of similar to the same size. So extras go into the pasta bins.
And I love having an extra bin for things that just don't quite have a place. Now, because everything is labeled and everything has a place, when it comes to grocery shopping and you're not sure what you need, you can go into your pantry, you can look at your basket, see what is full, what is empty. Instead of having just boxes, you don't know how full or empty they really are. Having the bins has helped me a lot to know what to get at the grocery store. So look at my pantry, write my list, and then head out to the store. Now there's one last thing I want to show you that I have wanted for many years. I had an old friend that had one and I thought it was genius. So we actually installed a Costco door. It goes directly to our garage so I can pull in my car. I can put my groceries in through that door and it goes right into my pantry. It's probably one of my most favorite things in my kitchen. Okay, everyone, have a good weekend. I'll see you next week. Bye.